Hi folks. Morning. And what an interesting morning it is too. Very popcorn-worthy events are happening in the US right now. It looks like a number of Agent of Doubt's predictions will both turn true and false. The popular vote may just swing to Saunders. But even if it does, as Agent of Doubt has detailed, given who the superdelegates are, and where their allegiances lie, i.e. their bank accounts, it's very, very unlikely that Saunders will even sway one or two of them over to his side. Net result is possibly going to be a popular uprising, but as we know from the recent protests over Occupy movement, and indeed throughout history, where the US government has even mobilized forces against its own veterans in the past, I think we pretty much all know what American democracy is currently like. Indeed, that's exactly the kind of thing that Saunders has been talking about quite passionately on the floor for over 30 years. The question is, what's going to happen now? It's obvious that they think that Saunders is a real threat. He's got two options, one of which is to negotiate some terms with the Democratic Party along the socialist leanings, or two, go as an independent. Now, it says in the news this morning on the BBC side that Obama has invited Saunders to the White House, presumably to talk about exactly those terms under which he gets some of what he wants for society in return for backing Clinton. Personally, I see a few problems with this. One is that Clinton's history of U-turns and not giving a damn about her own I won't even go into detail. Her history stands for itself. And the second is Saunders's decades on the floor and his passion. Given the choice of Saunders throwing his weight behind Clinton and going as an independent, whereby I think that he would get the disenfranchised vote not only from the Democratic Party, but also from the Republican Party. I wouldn't like to call it. I think I would edge towards him saying to himself, after all these decades, I now have a chance to actually do something. Why would I throw it away now and compromise? He does seem, from the little that I know from the news at this end, that he is a man of principle. You know, we've seen that in action. He's got where he is now off the backs of the money of the popular people, off the little bits coming off the many, rather than the large amounts coming off the few corporates. And his behaviour has been seen and witnessed in public. He travels cattle class, he eats at the same places that everybody else eats at. The massive crowds that he's drawn to the rallies are impressive. If I was in his position, I would be weighing this up very heavily. I would think that after all the decades of putting in the effort, that this was too historic a moment to pass up, and I would go independent and put all the chips on red or black or whatever. Or white. I don't know. I can't even remember. Roulette. That's the name of the game. Roulette. I don't know. Personally, I think it's too close to call. But given his history, given his leanings, given his behavior so far, I'm leaning towards him taking the risk and going independent in order to try and get the disenfranchised from both the Democrat and Republican side and romping home into the White House and being in the driving seat to make the changes that he's wanted to make. Interesting times ahead. More popcorn, please.